Natasha is given a job in Black Widow issue 2. 1 week prior to Natasha escaping S.H.I.E.L.D., a funeral is being held for Agent Elder's partner. On a nearby hill, Natasha overlooks the funeral with her sniper rifle, seeing assassins scouring the cemetery, looking for her, Maria, and Elder. She packs up and leaves. Natasha hides from the assassins, killing some of them silently as they continue searching for her and trying to get to Maria and Elder. One assassin makes it to Maria and Elder, but Natasha stabs him before he can get closer. The remaining assassin confronts her, talking to her in Russian. Natasha demands the man tell her who sent them and how he knew about the secret S.H.I.E.L.D. cemetery. The assassin says that there isn't anything that the Weeping Lion doesn't know, and once he has targeted someone, he never fails to get them. The assassin contacts his boss through an earpiece, showing Natasha that even the priest delivering the sermon is involved with them, and if she isn't quiet, the whole place will become a crater. Giving up, Natasha is knocked out and taken. Waking up in a destroyed warehouse, one of the assassins welcomes her to the lion's den. The man says that he will ask her a question and she will give him an answer. Natasha headbutts the man, freeing himself from the chair and dealing with the other assassins in the room. When she is finished, the weeping lion arrives, feeding the nearby caged tiger. Natasha says that she isn't his captive, but he says that he is unconcerned, since if Natasha knows who he is, she knows that there is no chance of escape. He gives her some files, making Natasha ask how these files exist, seeing as that she made sure there was never any record of herself. The Weeping Lion says he needs her to steal a key from the S.H.I.E.L.D. helicarrier, and if she tries to double-cross him, go to S.H.I.E.L.D. or go to the Avengers, he will make these files public. So reluctantly, Natasha agrees to help him. Pretty cool issue, a little bit of backstory on exactly what happened with that first issue, since we didn't really know what was going on. It looks like she's being double-crossing sort of stuff. And I guess this sort of fits into her place in the MCU now as well, since after Winter Soldier, all her records got released to the public and everything, and she was under scrutiny from the government and everything for being, I guess, a Russian spy before she was a S.H.I.E.L.D. agent. So I guess that's sort of what's going to happen here. Maybe that it'll be the same outcome, the files will get released or someone will come into the possession of these files, maybe Maria Hill does, and uses them to keep her in S.H.I.E.L.D. and keep her in check or something, or maybe they get released or something. It'd be pretty interesting to find out. Also, this Weeping Lion guy, this Plachliev guy, he's kind of weird. We don't know who he is. Maybe he's someone from her past, coming to exact revenge or something. We obviously know he's Russian, so he's got some ties there with Natasha. So it's gonna be interesting to find out who this guy is. Maybe he's an ex-partner or ex-KGB agent or something. It'll be pretty interesting to find out, and exactly what he wants as well. He wants a key. Keys open stuff, so what does he want to open? It'll be pretty interesting to find out. I like what Mark Waid's doing in this. I think it's pretty cool. I'm gonna give this comic a 9 out of 10.